Well, the earthquake left more than 220,000 people dead and over 300,000 injured. The tragedy unleashed an unprecedented flood of international aid, with $13.5 billion earmarked for the crisis. But the UN says that 2 years on, less than half of that amount was actually released. Then came the worst cholera epidemic in Haiti's recent history that continues to this day. It's now killed around 9,000 people. And while the government prides itself on reconstruction projects, there are more than 85,000 people still living in tent camps. Radio host Solomon Commission believes those organisations distributing the aid to Haiti don't have the people's interests at heart.
It's much of the same with the Western involvement, just meddling and meddling. Much of the worldwide efforts have been coming from disingenuous sources, have been coming from Western entities like the United States, France, and so forth, who have never had Haiti's best interests in mind in the first place. Haiti is a country that's overrun with non-government organizations, NGOs. And so much of the aid that's coming into Haiti has strings attached to it. The Martelly administration, in essence, is a puppet of the United States. And so, without a doubt, there's current corruption that is throughout the Haitian government. The United States gives aid to these countries with many, many strings attached because they want to control their internal politics, because they want to plunder and expropriate and exploit the resources of countries like Haiti.